There are a lot of 4K TVs available to choose from, complete with a wide variety of prices and performance. The good part is, since the market is crowded, we are lucky to find a 4K TV or even more without breaking our banks. In this video, we will take a look at what I think are the best budget 4K TVs of 2021. And of course, to see the most up-to-date prices and find out more information about these TVs, you can check out the links in the description below. We're starting the list with the best all-rounder, the TCL50S 435 4 Series 50-inch 4K Ultra HD TV. The TCL 4 Series is so inexpensive and capable, you might start to question why there are any multi-thousand dollar TVs at all. If you are just looking for an easy-to-use TV with a decent picture, this is an excellent place to start. It's ridiculously affordable, offers 4K resolution in a wide range of sizes, and has the same excellent Roku interface as that company's mega-popular streaming devices. The 50S 435 is a plain-looking TV, which is not surprising for a budget set. Its screen is surrounded on the top and sides by narrow, glossy plastic bezels. The bottom bezel is slightly thick and holds a silver TCL logo in the middle. The screen is supported by a pair of V-shaped glossy black plastic feet that match the bezels and sides. A power connector can be found on the left side of the back of the TV, facing left. All other connections are on the right side of the back panel, facing right. They include three HDMI ports, a USB port, an Ethernet port, a 3.5mm composite video port, a 3.5mm headphone jack, an optical audio output, and an antenna cable connector. For smart features, the 4 Series uses Roku TV, which provides the same apps and services as a Roku media streamer. Most big names are available, including Amazon Prime Video, Apple TV, Disney Plus, Hulu, Netflix, and YouTube, though Twitch remains absent from Roku's library. The TV is also Apple AirPlay compatible, letting you stream content from your Mac or iOS device. WIDI Miracast enables wireless screen mirroring from Windows PC and some Android devices, but Google Cast isn't available for streamlined Android streaming. The TCL 50S 435 boasts a 4K TV firing full 3840 to 2160 resolution with direct backlighting and HDR support. The result is a relatively good viewing experience and a better viewing experience than you might expect at this price range. Next on the list, something that has unbeatable value for the money, the Hisense 43A6G, which is a 43-inch 4K Ultra HD. Hisense has decided to get aggressive with this A6G, a new 4K Ultra HD entry-level screen available in a huge array of screen sizes. This model is clearly attempting to persuade upgraders to make the jump to Ultra HD Dolby Vision and appears a good bet if you're shortlisting affordable large screens for gaming and TV watching. The TV uses a regular LED backlight but boasts Dolby Vision HDR to make the most of streaming content. The thin bezels and sleek design are nice in a budget model. The back is metal on the top and plastic on the bottom section. The inputs face to the side, so they should be easy to access if you wall mount the TV. There are tracks on the back that look like they could be for cable management. I like the way the A6G presents itself. The set does a good job balancing the technical compromises that come with a fairly budget price tag and all-important eye candy. The set employs 60Hz motion estimation motion compensation interpolation, which works really well. Appropriately named ultra smooth settings are available in smooth, standard, clear, film, and custom guides. The latter allows for manual adjustment of judder and blur reduction. This cocktail works well for sports and action shows, although some might find the soap opera effect a bit of a turnoff for movies. Coming in as the best 55-inch for the money, we have the Toshiba 55-inch C350 series LED 4K, which is made in 2021. If you're looking for a smart, big-screen TV with integrated streaming service apps and much, much more, then you'll definitely want to take a look at the Toshiba C350 series, a 4K Ultra HD TV that's optimized for Amazon services, though it comes with all the most popular streaming platforms like Disney Plus and Netflix. The C350 looks surprisingly stylish for an inexpensive TV. The top and sides of the screen are bezel-free, framed only by a narrow black plastic band that wraps around the back. A thin brushed metal strip runs along the bottom edge of the screen, angled slightly forward. The infrared receiver and indicator LED sit in a small clear enclosure below the center of the band, with a small power input button just behind it. Everything rests on two V-shaped metal legs located near the edges of the screen. You can also mount it on the wall. The Toshiba C350 runs Fire TV, and if you ever use the Fire TV stick, you'll recognize the interface. The smart TV OS on the C350 is fairly responsive. Apps launch in seconds, and there are plenty to choose from on the platform, pretty much every major one. The C350 series offers an incredible 4K Ultra HD with a 16:9 aspect ratio. This smart TV is a lot brighter than other similarly priced models, so if your living room receives a ton of light during the day, the C350 series is at an advantage. Fire TV fans have a new TVs to pick from in this size and price range, and the Toshiba 350 Fire TV should be among the top choices. It runs Fire TV well and has good overall color. With its color accuracy, low lag time, and responsive Fire TV, it sets itself apart from the crowd. Next, we have the best budget QLED TV, the Samsung 32-inch class QLED Q60A series, which is made in 2021 as well. The Samsung Q60A is its entry-level QLED model, aka an LCD TV with quantum dots. Those magical dots lets a Q60A perform better than many traditional LCDs that cost less, with far greater brightness and deeper, richer color with HDR content. Its skinny design also separates it from its bulkier brethren. The Samsung Q60A has a simple and minimalist design that's similar to its predecessor, the Samsung Q60T QLED. But like I said earlier, a notable change is that it's much thinner, which means it doesn't stick out as much when wall-mounted. The feet are now height-adjustable so that you can raise the TV higher if you need room to fit in a soundbar. The Samsung Q60A is this year's entry-level 4K QLED, meaning you'll get something of saving, though alongside some drops in specification compared to more premium models. As a Samsung Smart TV, you'll get the Tizen operating system, which is one of the best out there. With a well-organized home screen and a broad app support from Netflix and Disney Plus to Hulu for those in the US and Freeview Play for those in the UK, the Tizen platform works with Alexa and Google Assistant too. To tick off the most important boxes, the Q60A features 4K resolution and HDR support, alongside the dynamic HDR 10+ standard favored by Samsung, which uses additional metadata to make premium movies and TV shows look closer to as intended by their creators. And last, the most versatile one, we have the Vizio 43-inch, which is a 4K smart TV V-series. The V in the Vizio V-series TVs has always stood for value, but you could easily argue that it should stand for versatile instead, as it's one of the most feature-rich TVs in the budget category. With support for HDR, HDR10, HDR10+, Dolby Vision, and HLG, plus Chromecast built-in and an AirPlay, the V-Series is a veritable Swiss Army knife of budget TVs. Wrapped in a black plastic chassis, the Vizio V-Series looks similar to other sets in this class. It uses a pair of V-shaped legs, for example, positioned near each end of the set to support it on a tabletop. If you'd prefer a wall mount for this set, you should purchase a standard VESA 200x200mm bracket. Eschewing the standard smart TV systems from the likes of Roku and Google, Vizio uses its own proprietary smart TV interface, which as the years go by looks more and more like others such as Android TV and the revamped webOS from LG. And that's not necessarily a bad thing. It means the interface is familiar and easy to follow. With decent color accuracy and great response times for gaming, there's plenty to love about this budget-friendly TV. Its exceptionally low input lag makes it an okay choice for gaming and a decent TV for use as a PC monitor. Alright guys, we hit the bottom of this video. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you found this video to be helpful. If so, then please leave a like. And if you have any questions about the TVs mentioned in this video, you can leave a comment below and I will get back to you as soon as I can. Alright, take care and peace out.